Hello and welcome to another one of my videos. Things have been a little bit quiet on the video front from me and the reason is that I've just had a second skin cancer operation and I've been in stitches, so I haven't been able to do much. My wife also had an operation on her ankle, an ankle reconstruction, so she's been out of action too, so we've both been out of action. But I have my stitches out now and I'm back into it and looking now at where I got with this project here. The generation of electricity. This was the apparatus that the last one we got up to making. It works pretty decently, really, all handmade and everything. The only difficulty in the field trials was that in hotter climates, like when you get up into the 30s and 40 degrees Celsius, the rubber band that is used to run the motor on tends to get a little bit soft and snaps easily. But we'll be looking at a replacement for that possibly and what we can do about that in the future. Now, there were further developments on the whole situation, then what were they? Now, everything's functioning quite fine like this, but I do have to wind the handle reasonably fast. We're going from like a 15 centimeter big wheel to a smaller one, then down to the motor. If I wanted to put a water wheel or a windmill or some gravity feed to that, it would have to go quite slow with quite a bit of power, but still have that motor down there going very fast. That means we've got to gear it up. So we've got two wheels and then down to the small motor. How about if we put a third one? So this is what I did. I made one wheel going to a broom handle, to a wheel, to a broom handle, to the wheel again. And yes, indeed, it does go a lot faster. However, the big problem is that due to the resistances and forces, even though that wheel does go and picks up quite a bit of speed by the end of things, that first belt tends to slip and slide a lot. And so we need to do something about that. So the solution to the slipping belt is going from one to another and then to cogs, teeth on your wheels, which then go in nicely together. Now that opens up a huge subject of engineering, of making cogs and teeth, and even worse, if you can make them by hand. I've learnt huge amounts, and I can say that this one definitely does work, even though it's a little noisy. No slippage whatsoever, and in future videos we'll be looking at more of what I've been learning about making cogs. This is noisy, but it works really well. In future videos, we'll be looking at a lot more of the theory behind making cogs, what is important and what is not important in making of the cogs and the way that they function. It's been quite an exciting adventure.